Now, our first try, the good operating state, worked pretty well, but we had a few problems. So we're going to try again, and we're going to call this try the better operating state. So the better operating state really works on the same principle. We're going to continue our assumption that when the dryer outlet temperature is above 170 degrees, that's the regenerating state, and when it's below, that'll be the drying state. Except this time, instead of looking at one value to make that determination, we're going to look at an hourly average. And this should dampen or make that value a little bit more definitive, because before what we were having is the values went up and down a little bit before it went continuously upward. So in order to do that, we're going to take advantage of the tag average function in Asset Analytics. You can see it here in the equation. It's really the only change we're making. And we're going to take a 1 hour rolling average and use that to determine whether the drying outlet temperature goes above or below 170 degrees. The rest of it's the same. That should dampen it out and give us a better result. Once we have that configured, we're going to go ahead and backfill this data into the attribute or the tag associated with dryer A. So we're going to be putting the data into a Pi point because we have a little bit more confidence that we're going to be right. And then we'll use Pi Vision to build a trend to take a look at the results. Now, as a preview, what we're going to find out, hopefully you'll get this result, is that we've really got a third operating state. So if you look at the trend, you can see that the states defined by our analytic, the green line, are much more pronounced. So we have a good start and end of the regenerating cycle. But what becomes more obvious is that there's sort of a period of time in between the drying and regeneration cycles of each cycle or each period here that's outlined in red. And it turns out that there is a time when the dryer is neither in drying or regenerating mode, where it's just kind of sitting idle. And we're going to call that the standby state. So there's actually a third state. We won't take care of it in the better operating state, but we'll probably get it next time when we go to the best. But at any rate, let's go ahead and configure the better operating state and see if we can match these results. So we're back in Pi System Explorer, and we're looking at the My Dryer State analytic that we built in the last exercise, and we're going to want to upgrade it to be the better analytic. So if you go in your lab workbook, you can select the equation for the better analytic, get it into the clipboard, and let's just go ahead and paste that over what we have currently. So if you go back down to the analytic editor here, just do a Control A to select everything and go ahead and paste in the new analytic. You'll see that it overwrites what's there, and we've now changed our if statement, the very first statement, to use the tag average of the outlet temperature. So we're going to use a rolling 1 hour average for the outlet temperature to check to see if it's over 170 degrees. And this should eliminate the problem we saw with the good drying state. What we're going to want to do is we're going to backfill the results of this equation into the Pi tag that's associated with dryer A. And so we're going to want to run the analytic and backfill it from the dryer A element. But what we have to do before we get to that step is we have to go ahead and check our analytic in so that it gets checked into AF and becomes available by the dryer A element. In order to do that, if you go up to the top, you'll see there's a check-in button. Now you'll notice next to the My Dryer State analytic, there's a little red check mark. That means that our analytic is still checked out to us. And in order to commit it, we have to hit the check-in button. And once you do that, you'll see that the red check disappears. So everything's checked in. We're all set to go. Now let's move to the Dryer A element. And to get there, we have to go back to the Elements view of Pi System Explorer. Make sure up at the top in the Elements hierarchy you have Dryer A selected, since that's the one we're going to backfill from. And then select the My Dryer State analytic. Now, in order to make to backfill, we have to start this analytic up. So what will happen is here, we'll start it up and the asset analysis service will pick it up and be able to support the backfilling function that we're going to request. So to start it up, once it's selected, just go up to the top and click on the green arrow. If we wait just a couple of seconds, you'll see that a green check mark will appear next to the My Dryer State analytic, which means that the service has picked it up and it's all set to go. Then we just go down and right click on that analytic and drop down in the dialog till you see from the list, backfill and recalculate. And what you're going to do is specify the start and end time, the time range that you want to backfill the analytic for. So go ahead and type in there January 1st, 2019 to December 31st, 2019. So we're going to go ahead and backfill this analytic through the entire year because we're pretty confident we've got things right. Not only that, but this will give us a year's worth of data to test the analytic on. So if there's anything that happens during that year, we should be able to see the anomalies and respond to it. Below, you see a couple of options. The first one says, by default, to leave the existing data and fill in all the gaps. What this means is, as the analytic runs, if there's already a value for the timestamp that the analytic wants to post the data into the PyArchive for, it won't do it. It'll leave all the data there. But we're going to want to start fresh, since this is a brand new analytic. So I'm going to go ahead and click permanently delete existing data. And this basically will rewrite everything for that time period fresh from this analytic, which will give us a much clearer picture in this case, because we really want to know what this thing's doing. We don't want any old data. We have nothing we want to keep. There's also a choice to recalculate dependent analysis. That means if we had some inputs to our analysis that came from another asset analytic, that would basically go back and recalculate those analytics first before calculating this one. Sometimes these analytics can depend on each other and get quite complicated. This isn't the case here. We've got a fairly simple one that just deals with basically just one tag, one attribute, and does something with it. So we really don't need to check that box in this case. And once we're set to go, and I think we are, you go ahead and click on the start. And if you look up by the analytic, you'll see a little bar graph that shows the progress that the analysis service is making in backfilling our results. And within a few seconds, it's done. So now we've added the results of our analytics to the PyArchive for Dryer A. Next, we'll go to PyVision and build a trend of this data to see how well our analytic worked. So return to PyVision so we can build a trend to check out our results. So we're going to want to build a brand new PyVision display. So just click on the new display button up at the top. And this gives us a blank PyVision canvas. The other thing we have to make sure of is that we have the default symbol set to be a trend, which is this one in the very corner. And then we'll go ahead and navigate our dryer AF hierarchy. We'll start at dryers, select dryer A, since that's the element we used for our test. And we'll go ahead and drag out a couple of attributes. First, the operating state, which is the results of our calculation. And the other one is the outlet temperature. Now we don't see any meaningful results right away because the data we backfilled for is back in 2019. So we'll have to change the time range of the PyVision display. So I'll go ahead and change the start time to be January 1st, 2019. And then I'll change the end time to be, let's say, January 15th. 2 week period ought to be pretty good. Give us a good view. Otherwise, there's just too much clutter on the display or on the trend. So we'll drag that out, get rid of a little bit of moving things around here. Okay, we can take a good look at it here. So the orange is the outlet temperature, and the blue is the result of our state analytic, and it looks pretty good. We've done most of the trends look pretty good. We've got things cleaned up pretty well. And as you can see, if you scroll over 2 weeks at a time, you start to be able to see this standby state that we were talking about in the PowerPoint. This is the state we need to cover. That way we've completely got a good handle on things, and we've accounted for what's going on in these dryers at any point in time. So let's take another crack at this with the best operating state in the next exercise to see if we can accommodate or account for that standby state.